By now, I think everyone is all aware of the condition of Sheikh Zak Zaki. He is in need of urgent medical care. The Nigerian government is not allowing his release. And what they're doing is feeding us a lie. They're telling us that his release depends on the orders of the court. But the court has already issued the order for his release. So the government is lying to us. His medical condition is so terrible, he's in so much pain that he hasn't slept for 10 days. So this situation is an emergency. Since the news of the deteriorating health of the Sheikh reached us, there's been a fresh round of protest in Nigeria. What was the answer of the Nigerian government to the peaceful protests? More brutality. To my brothers and sisters around the world, I say this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is testing us. Imam Mahdi is watching us. We have up until Monday to give our best results. Now, there have been protests around the world globally. There have been protests in Pakistan, in Iran, in Canada, in the UK, in the US, but that's definitely not enough. Turkey, other places, people, Indonesia, people are trying. That's not enough. This week is very sensitive for us. We need to come out in numbers. We need to use every opportunity to create awareness about the situation of the Sheikh. This means Dua Kumail this week. Our Friday prayers this week. These are golden opportunities. In addition to that, brothers and sisters, we need public action and we need to rally outside. We need rallies in different cities around the world. Look this weekend and see which day works best for you. If Friday works best for you, come out on Friday. If Sunday works best for you, come out on Sunday. But come out in numbers. Right now, the enemy is apathy and indifference. We don't want to be like the Tawabin. The Tawabin heard about Imam Hussein. They knew about the mission. They knew that there was someone who was oppressed. The Tawabin, they acted late. About 6 months later, they came. They came to the assistance of Islam and the Muslims. But what's the difference between them and the Shuhada of Karbala? How can they even be compared? My final message is for my brothers and sisters in Nigeria. I want you to know that the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam has not forgotten you. You stand strong. The promises of Allah are true. Allah tells us in the Quran, Nasrum min Allah wa fathun qareeb. InshaAllah, Allah is with you. And we will also be coming out in numbers this weekend to show you our support. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.